Good morning. Today is Friday, March 17th, 2023, and it is day number 433 in my fasting journey and day number 76 in my exercise journey. So these days I am doing OMAD, where I have a meal every morning around 7, and then when I finish my food, I fast until the next morning around 7. And the exception to that rule is on Fridays. On Fridays, I have a dinner refeed with my nephews because I have a play date with them, and that play date coincides with their dinner time. And something that I've been doing this year is eating dinner with them, which has made them happy, and it's really made me happy to get to have a nice meal with some of my most favorite people in the entire world. And so what we're having today, I have no clue. I usually find out when I get to their house. So I am going to have to let you know in tomorrow's video what I ultimately had for today's refeed. So in terms of my exercise, so something that I've been kind of like focusing on recently is kind of like increasing the speed that I pedal my bike. And I definitely felt that yesterday. My legs were so sore and I just did not have it in me to do a bike ride yesterday. So what I actually did was a 10-minute session on my whole body vibration machine and a yin yoga practice. I did the yin yoga workout from Travis Eliot's Ultimate Yogi program. So what I wanted to talk about today is if you've had an off day on your weight loss journey, maybe you have, gotten on the scale and seen a number you don't like. Maybe you are kind of like starting over from the very beginning and you kind of like feel frustrated and annoyed. Maybe, you know, you've had one of those days where your mind was like really wild and out of control, and to get some relief, you kind of like gave in to your cravings. Maybe you've had a day where you set off and you started a fast, but you ended that fast prematurely. Maybe you had like a day where you fell off the wagon with your diet. What I want you to do if you've had one of those days is I want you to, first of all, know that this happens to all of us. Like every single person on a weight loss journey has experienced this. And so you're definitely not alone. And I want you to remember that. And then I want you to kind of like forgive yourself for whatever it is that you kind of like think that you've done. And then I want you to kind of like let it go. And letting it go means that you're not going to think about this thing anymore. You're not going to dwell upon it. And then I want you to do something to lift your spirits and to make you feel good. Something that you love. Something that you know will bring a smile to your face. And then I want you to pick yourself up and keep going in the direction of your ultimate goal. Because basically, we have this desire, and that's point A, and the accomplishment of that desire is point B, and everything that kind of like happens in the middle, like all these kind of like setbacks and these obstacles and kind of like what we've perceived to be like these failures, none of this stuff is going to mean anything to us when we get to our ultimate goal, when we get to our destination. And I can tell you from personal experience that here I am, I'm at 117.8 pounds. I'm essentially at my ultimate goal weight. And I'm not kind of like thinking about anything from the past. I'm not thinking about any of my struggles and obstacles from the past. Basically, here I am. I'm just kind of like really happy with, you know, what's kind of like happening in my life. You know, I just feel like this huge sense of accomplishment that I've come pretty close to getting to my ultimate goal weight. And this is something that has eluded me for like so long. And basically, when you get to your ultimate goal, whatever that may be, you're going to kind of feel like the same way. You're going to feel like so happy and so excited. You're going to feel like a huge sense of accomplishment. You're going to feel like a huge sense of relief. You're going to feel like a burden has been lifted off your shoulders. You're going to feel like all that time, all that energy, all that hard work that you expended on getting to this goal, you're going to feel like it was all worth it. And you're not going to be thinking about it. I assure you, you're not going to be thinking about any of the obstacles kind of like along the way on your journey. And I know this from firsthand experience. I assure you that I'm not thinking about that time when I gained like 2.2 pounds after having eaten a salad that was chock full of feta cheese like early on in my fasting journey. I'm not even thinking about that ill-fated water fast of 2015 where I had basically lost basically all of my weight, but then when I broke that fast with junk, I, you know, gained all the weight that I had lost plus an extra 70 something pounds. I am not thinking about all the times when I tried to give up drinking soda and found my way back to it. I'm not thinking about all the failed attempts at fasting. I'm not thinking about all the times when I fell off the wagon. these days, you know, all of this stuff is just kind of like a distant memory. It's just becoming a blur to me, especially as I get deeper and deeper and deeper into this journey. And, you know, back then, when these things were happening, I definitely thought about them. I definitely dwelled upon them and, definitely looked back on them with like sorrow and regret. But, you know, that didn't serve any purpose except to make me feel bad. And it usually kind of like sent me running to my comfort, which was soda and food. And so it serves no purpose at all to kind of like, you know, dwell upon, you know, this stuff. We can't change like anything that has happened in the past. And so just let it go. Don't think about it anymore. You're like too good for that. You're too good to kind of like, you know, spend your time thinking about like what you perceive to be your failures. So I just want you to let it go. And what I want you to focus on, if you need something to focus on, what I want you to focus on is like seeing yourself in your mind as already having achieved your ultimate goal, whatever that may be. I want you to see that you've already accomplished that goal. And I want you to kind of like even see yourself posting a comment to me in the comment section of one of my videos telling me that you've achieved your goal. And I want you to see me like responding to your comment and congratulating you and telling you how happy I am and excited I am and how proud I am of you. I want you to, you know, see that. I want you to feel like all the good feelings that you would feel as if you've achieved that goal. And what's going to happen is that you keep thinking about this, you know, over and over and over again in your head, and you're going to kind of like push it out in your reality. You're going to see it show up in your reality. This is kind of like all part of telling that new story. And this is something that I've been talking a little bit about this week. And so I want you to kind of like focus on that rather than dwelling upon, you know, the obstacles and the failures and the setbacks that kind of like have happened along the way. Because I promise you, when you get to your ultimate goal, you're not going to be thinking about this stuff. You're not going to be thinking about how long it took you to get to your ultimate goal. You're not going to be thinking about any of that. You're just going to be thinking about how happy you are that you're finally here. And so you can do that now. You know, focus on that like in your head, like right now. And I assure you that you will see that in your reality, like one of these days. And so that's today's video. I hope that you have an absolutely amazing Friday and just a wonderful start to your weekend. And I will see you tomorrow. Take care. Bye.